Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. Please make sure to hit that subscribe button. Also, you may want to watch my first Keurig video, part one unboxing. This video will make a lot more sense. If you guys watched it, you'll remember that I ordered the Keurig K Cafe special edition and I was having issues with my milk frother. I tried so many times. I tried like even more after making that video and I just couldn't get my milk to froth. Now I was using almond milk, but the whole point of me buying that machine was because the website said that it would work totally fine with almond milk. So I ended up calling customer service. When I called customer service, the agent asked me a few questions that at the time I thought were so weird. Like first she asked me, when did I buy my milk and how old was my milk? My first instinct was it's not expired, but she asked, when did I buy it? Did I buy it yesterday? Did I buy it a week ago? So at that time I had bought my milk like 4 days before making that video and I had opened it like right before. So she mentioned that the older the milk, the less froth I would get. And then also once you open the milk, the fats in the milk start to break down, causing less froth. So, but she also ordered or sent me a new frother. So I just received that. So I'm gonna see if it was a frother or if it was just my milk. Also, I was using store brand almond milk. So this time around, I went and bought Silk almond milk and Silk almond creamer. So I'm gonna see if it was the milk or the frother. So I'm gonna test them out now and see what happens. So as you can see, the frother worked a lot better this time. I don't know if it was the silk milk or the actual frother itself or a combo of the two. I'm kind of leaning towards the milk. I feel like Keurig is a little bougie and needs name brand milk. So that's probably what did it. I'm gonna try with my creamer next time and see how that goes. But for now, I think this is a winner. I even had to scoop out the froth with a spoon. So whereas before I could never have done that, I just poured right out. So yeah, there you have it, guys. That's my update on my whole frothing fiasco. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Please make sure to subscribe and click on notifications and leave me a comment down below. Until next time, bye guys.